Dipietro is here. Shipyard is the place at Twin River. Briskets on the menu today. Now, we have done, first of all, welcome. Thanks for coming in today. Great to have you here today.
Thank you.
We've done stuff with Shipyard before, and the food that's been brought in is, like, out of control. It is so, so good.
Absolutely.
And you got a full staff up there that really works hard to make sure that everybody who comes to the restaurant gets a great meal.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they work really hard to make sure every single person that comes in hungry gets fed, you know, and leaves happy.
And leaves happy and right. full. Today, we're going to make brisket, something that a lot of people probably make around St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
It is around all year long. What are the ingredients we need to put this together?
We're going to start off with 24 ounces of pineapple juice for the marinade, all of our liquids, also 8 ounces of orange juice. We have 100 milliliters of bourbon. I also have 4 ounces of chopped red onion, 3 garlic cloves, a cinnamon stick, and some fresh fruit. We have mango, half a pineapple, and 1 whole orange chopped up. It's going to get thrown right in with the brisket. And
okay.
We can let it sit.
And if we can just talk about the brisket itself, because we had mentioned, you know, I was talking to you
Absolutely.
Earlier saying, when people go to the market and they buy a brisket, a lot of times it, you know, it's a larger piece of meat.
Right, like 12 to 15 pounds
you,
on average.
You cook it and it kind of shrinks right down. So what
Absolutely.
Do we need to look for?
When we're cooking it, we just want to make sure the meat's fork tender. You know, we cook it at a low temperature so we can render the fat and the tissue inside the meat.
Right.
So it tends to be a tougher meat, tougher cut of meat. So we cook it for a longer period at a lower temperature.
And I would imagine that a lot of the acidities in like the orange juice and the juices will kind of also break it down and
Absolutely.
Kind of make
yep.
it a lot more tender as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. They contribute to breaking down the connective tissue and the fat.
Good
meat.
Stuff. All right. So we are going to put this together. We'll talk about everything that's going on at Shipyard at Twin River. Back to you.
For now, we want to send it back into the kitchen. Michaela, take it away.
Thanks so much. I'll tell you what, if you haven't been to Shipyard over at Twin River, it is such a cool place. The vibe in there, it seems like you've totally escaped and gone into a different building. Dan's here to help us make our brisket.
Absolutely.
And for that, we need a nice marinade.
Right. We're going to start off by grabbing our brisket. This is a 2-pound piece of brisket. It's a...
What part of the animal is the brisket?
It's actually the pectoral muscles of the cow.
Okay.
So there's a lot of body weight that comes down on the cow, and in order to sustain the body weight, it needs to have a lot of connective tissue inside. We're going to put some red onion in here.
Okay.
Start off with our solids, a stick of cinnamon, 3 garlic cloves. Some fresh fruit. You got 1 whole orange chopped up.
I'm using that nice citrus.
2 mangoes, that's right, some citrus.
We just learned earlier, citrus
acids.
Is good for your skin. Very nice.
Right, and it also helps break down the fats and the connective tissue inside the meats. Half a pineapple in there. Now we're going to go on to our liquids. You got 24 ounces of pineapple juice.
Okay.
Also have 8 ounces of orange juice.
Yum.
And to finish it off, we got 100 milliliters of bourbon whiskey.
Which, of course, will cook off. The alcohol will cook off, but really provides
Absolutely.
A nice flavor to that.
Right.
Now, how long will this sit and marinate for?
We're going to want to cover and refrigerate it and let it sit for about 24 hours. The longer you let it sit, the better the flavor, obviously. You can let it marinate for up to 48 hours, but 24 hours should do it.
But that's nice. We can prep this beforehand so that way it's ready to go
when
we need it for our party or whatever you're doing. Maybe it's just a Friday night or something.
Right.
Well, now you have the marinade, and we're going to show you how it all comes together when we come back. Over at Twin River Casino, if you haven't been there yet, really fun place. Great drinks, great food, briskets on the menu. When we last left, we had it marinating.
Right. We had it in the fridge covered marinating.
Where are we in the prep process now?
Well, right now we're about to slice the brisket. We actually cooked it at 325 degrees for about 4 to 5 hours until it was tender. And then we immediately cooled it after cooking it for easier slicing. You don't have to cool it, but it does make it easier to work with once you go to slice it.
All right. That's what's in front of Brendan right now.
Right.
That's my job. I
so how do,
washed my
how
hands, punched in, I'm ready to
brisket?
Go.
We always want to slice it against the grain because it is a tougher cut of meat.
You said on an angle, sort of, right?
Right.
So should I go all the way to the bottom with
Yeah,
that?
You can go all the way to straight down, just in nice thin strips.
Nice.
It's a good start.
Right. It's not bad.
Keep going, buddy.
Thank
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely.
And then do you have some already pre-cut in that pan right
yep,
there?
Yep, I got some warming up right here for us to start building our brisket sandwich with.
What have you added to it? There's a lot of juice, a lot
it's,
of liquid in
there. This is actually beef stock.
Okay.
So it's just beef base. We're going to throw our sliced brisket right on top of a sweet Portuguese roll that we use.
Ooh.
Beautiful.
Sounds so good.
Should I just slice the entire thing, or how many do we need here?
You can go through halfway.
About halfway, about
right.
one more maybe?
Yeah, that'll work.
All right.
And Once that's done, we can put that aside.
Okay.
And I'm exhausted.
So we got our brisket. Now we're gonna top our sandwich with a slice of provolone.
Yum.
Gonna throw some barbecue over the top there.
Is this house-made barbecue over at Shipyard?
It is, actually. It's a mango barbecue sauce that we make ourselves. And we're gonna bake this in the oven just to melt the cheese.
Right. Oh, gosh.
That just gets better and better.
I know, I didn't know it was going to be all melty and crispy. Now, while that goes, tell us about the events that are coming up.
Oh, there's so many things happening up there.
Right, at the end of the month, we have a beer dinner coming up on July 30th. Mm-hmm. It's at 6 p.m. It features five courses, five beers and four courses. One's a dessert, the other three are hot entrees.
Yum.
We have chipotle lime hog wings. We have an heirloom tomato salad coming up. Yeah.
Sounds so good. And then, of course, pairing the appropriate beer with each course.
Right, right. We're pairing the beers. They're actually craft Shipyard beers that we feature at the bar. And it's going to,
sounds like a good time.
Right, the rest of the information's
online. If you don't know what to get, I remember we were there, we just did the sampler.
We went for the opening,
and you can just sample them all and decide which goes best with what you're having, which
Absolutely.
Is awesome. And the vibe in there is so much fun, whether you're in there for a drink or just having dinner. It's great, isn't it, Chef?
Yeah, it's really nice. We make sure that everybody that comes in leaves happy, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you betcha.
Right.
Seats around the bar, there are seats at tables. It even has, you know, it's that wood feel. You feel like you're inside of like a barrel or something. You know, it gets really good vibe.
We also run monthly specials, so there's a variety. It's not always the same menu. It's constantly changing every month. It's
I like that.
Always something new. And what's great about what you've prepared here today is, you know, I sometimes struggle with preparing things, but it seems fairly simple.
Right. It is.
Someone wants to try
brisket sandwich, absolutely. It's easy to
do
at home.
It's good for leftovers, too, if you think about it.
All you need is a pot and your marinating liquid and some time, patience, and that's about it.
Very nice.
The patience, I don't know if he'd do so well with, but we're getting there.
I may need you to drop by my home kitchen and help me with this.
Absolutely.
A little project.
I can do that, absolutely.
All right, so let's check on our sandwich there.
All right. Yep.
Hopefully our cheese is getting
Should be nice and melty.
Outstanding. It's like watching Edison at work. Look at you. You got it all under control. Beautiful. Oh, man, look at that.
I feel like I would snack on that brisket just alone.
So now that's nice and hot, we're just going to transfer it.
Cheese has melted beautifully.
And we're going to get this out of the way.
And then what are we looking at here, Chef? Does that go on the sandwich,
Yep,
too?
Absolutely. We can top it off with some fried onions now.
Whoa.
And we put a toothpick through, and that's
that's so good.
That's our barbecue brisket sandwich.
Is that always on the menu? Because I know you rotate it a lot.
It's a fixed item. It is always on the menu, and it's a favorite. It is a favorite. It sells quite well. So.
I can see why.
Along with
so good.
We offer other, you know, a potato stacker as well. We offer a maker's mark.
What's a potato stacker?
It's actually potato chips that are baked in the oven with a buffalo cream cheese sauce, and it's topped with shredded lettuce, tomato. It's a large plate. It's more than one person can eat, so it's good for about two people.
That sounds like a challenge.
I need to sit down after that.
Potato chips and buffalo, that sounds really good. All right.
Chef, thank you so much, sir.
Absolutely.
If they want the recipe, Michaela, they can get it at our website. They can learn more. It's all at roadshow.com.